Hi everybody, I'm Jana and I'm almost a gamer. And I've been thinking lately how much fun it is playing games and on occasion how great it feels when you win a game. But I've realized that there are some games that I do really well at. I'm just great at them and I tend to win a lot. But then there's a whole lot of other games that I do the opposite. I hardly ever win. I usually come in like second to last or so. And it's made me think some more, like, why are there specific games that I can excel at and other games I can't? It's been a little difficult putting my finger on it. And then that made me remember, I'm dyslexic. When I was younger, I couldn't read on my own and I hated math. Really just struggled in school, and it wasn't until I was a teenager that I was diagnosed with dyslexia. This like changed my world because up until that point I saw myself as someone who was dumb and people would just tell me I was lazy and didn't work hard enough in school. So to learn that my brain was actually working differently and processing information differently than other people's really changed everything, and I realized that I had to learn how to cope and that I would eventually learn how to read and achieve in academics. And I did. I learned how to read phonetically. I graduated from college at the top of my class. It wasn't our college, but still pretty cool. And I have to say, I haven't really thought about dyslexia as something that was a problem in my life for a really long time until I started gaming. Now there are all sorts of ways that dyslexia plays out in my life. For example, I really struggle with spelling, so a game like Scrabble isn't really my jam. But on the other hand, there are different factors that kind of crop up. For example, I really struggle with keeping multiple facts and figures in my head all at one time. And I also struggle with logic. I always think of really creative answers, while other people, like my husband, is very logical. The logical answers take a little bit longer for me to get to. And that's because of being dyslexic. I tend to favor the right side of my brain over the left side. The left side is designated to reading, writing, logical, and analytical thought, while the right side is designated to creative fields like art and music, holistic thinking, and intuitive thought. So they're very different. That's why dyslexics tend to struggle with reading, because they tend to use the right side of their mind for processing words and even like figures and whatnot. And the right side of the brain is not good at retaining large amounts of information. It's not good at keeping it on easy recall to look back upon and analyze. So games that require analytical deduction, like Sleuth, are really difficult for me. And a game like even Memoir 44 that really involves tactical strategy is not something that I can excel at. I still enjoy these games and I do my darndest, but my husband definitely has a foot above me because he is more left-brained. So in doing a little bit of research on dyslexia recently, I learned that it affects 1 in 5 people, which is mind-boggling to me because when I was growing up, I felt like I was the only one. So it kind of opened my eyes, and being a somewhat of a gamer now, it's been interesting to me to see how differently my brain works. While there are games that I struggle to excel at, there are great games that come very naturally to me and I do wonderfully at, like games that involve pattern recognition, like Flatline or even Sangrata, Codenames. And then other games that involve like creative puzzle solving, like Number 9. Games that are more holistic in theme and also in presentation. For example, Concordia is a game I recently learned and I find extremely intuitive for my learning style, and I love that game. I would love to hear from other dyslexic gamers, what are the games that you enjoy and why? I think it would be really encouraging for each other just to kind of know what games are out there that do play to a dyslexic brain. So I just want to encourage any younger gamers out there that have dyslexia. I know what it feels like when everyone else is excelling at what you find extremely difficult, like learning how to read and math. And I just want you to know that there are a lot of games out there that will play to your abilities and will be able to highlight and showcase your strengths, like the creative puzzle solving and pattern recognition and intuitive thought. Like, all of these things can come through in a variety of games. So don't be afraid to try them. You may be amazed at your abilities. There is a whole lot of potential for people in the creative fields. We need creative thinkers out there. So just know that you do have value and you do have potential. And just one more note, if you are not dyslexic and you may be playing with someone who you don't really know very well, just bear this video in mind. There are those gamers who struggle with analysis paralysis. There's also quite a few gamers out there that have dyslexia and maybe just read and process information slower than you do. Just a thought to bear in mind the next time you're playing with a new gamer. So, is this something that you can relate to? Would you like to see some more segments about dyslexic gaming? Let me know in the comments. I would love to hear from you. I hope everybody has an awesome day, and thanks for watching the Token Punch Lunch.